Ladies and gentlemen, a warm Rockefeller welcome for the Kingston Trio. Let's hear it.
Of this old town, that's where my true love lays around. She sits down upon her mother's knee and tells him what she never will tell me. Oh, and it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard?
Not yet.
And the one who never did love you. Oh, and it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard? Great God, and the one who never will be true. You're burning me.
Well, the first time I saw my true love, she was standing by door. And the last time I saw her false hearted smile, she was dead on that barroom floor.
Oh, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard? To love one who never did love you. Oh, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard? Great God, to love one who never will be true.
Well, now who's gonna kiss your pretty lips? Who's gonna hold your little hand?
I'll do that.
And who's gonna do well? You know what?
We all will.
When I'm down in that promised land.
Oh, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard? To love one who never did love you. Oh, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard? Great God, to love one who never will be true. Well, took her drinking and gambling, took her there, you start for the ground. Well, this hard liquor place is a low down disgrace. It's the meanest damn place in this town.
Yeah.
Oh, and it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard?
It is.
To love one who never did love you,
you.
Oh, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard? Great God, to love one who never will be true.
You know,
oh, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard? The love one who never did love you.
Yes, it's
so hard, it's hard, it's hard. Great God, the love one who never will be true.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Boy, you're wild. You're really wild. Thank you very much. We're going to have some fun here, whether we like it or not. All right.
Tres, Johnny.
And now, before your very eyes, while our pale young virgins pass out amongst you, so to speak.
You can get more.
Folks, if you like this kind of music, if we haven't received $7 million by November 1st, was that reserved for the clergy? I could beg anywhere, you know.
Hey, Mon.
I believe they told you we are making a videotape of this show this evening, and there may be certain pauses every now and then for tuning purposes. One of our musicians doesn't have a very good ear, and you'll find out which one later.
My ear bleeding again?
Yum, yum, yum.
This might be a good time for you to talk amongst yourselves. They are.
Or better than that, why don't we all just take our clothes off and criticize each other? Have a good time in here.
Yeah. Oh, God.
One, two, and three jolly coachmen sat in an English tavern. Three jolly coachmen sat in an English tavern. And they decided, and they decided, and they decided to have another flagon. Landlord filled the flowing bowl until it doth run over. Landlord filled the flowing bowl until it doth run over. For to make him mayor I be, for to make him mayor I be, for to make him mayor I be. Tomorrow we'll be sober.
It's only a song.
Headed to the man who drinks our ale and goes to a great mellow. Here's to the man who drinks our ale and goes to a great mellow. He lives as he ought to live, lives as he ought to live, lives as he ought to live, and dies jolly good fellow. Ho, ho, ho.
Here's to the man who drinks water pure and goes to bed quite sober.
Yeah. Here's to the man who drinks water pure and goes to bed quite sober.
He falls as the leaves do fall,
falls as the leaves do fall, falls as the leaves do fall.
He'll die before October.
Ha, ha, ha.
Here's to the maid who steals a kiss and runs to tell her mother.
Here's to the maid who steals a kiss and runs to tell her mother.
She's a foolish, foolish thing.
She's a foolish, foolish thing. She's a foolish, foolish thing.
For she'll not get another.
Pity. Here's to the maid who steals a kiss and stays to steal another. Here's to the maid who steals a kiss and stays to steal another. She's a boon to all mankind. She's a boon to all mankind. She's a boon to all mankind. For she'll soon be a mother.
Thank you. Another super crowd in here. Have more to drink, because you sound a lot better when you drink, really.
Oh, yeah. It's like the old chick thing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
More you have to drink, the better we sound.
Yeah, that's right.
A lot of people ask me what it's like traveling with the group nowadays. It's been like 30 years since we started, 31 years, as a matter of fact. And the big thing that I've noticed, the big change, has been packing for the road. In the old days, we used to just grab a suitcase and some live ducks. And lonely nights on the road. No, we cut all this crap out, you know. The big thing nowadays is you have to line the stuff up on the bed before you go away from home. You got your poly grip. The extra bifocals for changing strings on stage.
Come on.
This next song was written by a great Canadian writer by the name of Gordon Lightfoot, and it's called The Early Morning Rain.
In the early morning rain, with a dollar in my hand, with an aching in my heart, and my pockets full of sand, I'm a long way from home, and I miss my darling so. In the early morning rain, with no place to go,
out on runway number 9, big 707 said go. But I'm stuck here on the ground, where the cold winds blow. Well, the liquor tasted fine, and the women all were fast.
There she goes, my friend, she's rolling out at last. Hear the mighty engines roar, I'll see the silver winds on high. She's a winging westward bound, high above the clouds she'll fly, where the morning rain don't fall and the sun always shines.
Chivet Pine on my home. In about 3 hours' time,
this old airport's got me down. It's no earthly good to me, 'cause I'm stuck here on the ground, cold and drunk as I can be. You can't jump a jet plane like you can a freight train,
so I'd best be on my way in the early morning rain. You can't jump a jet plane like you can a freight train, so I'd best be on my way in the early morning rain. So I'd best be on my way in the early morning rain.
People upstairs. You know, I remember a theater. A friend of mine worked in the Fox Theater in Atlanta, and he said that he was usher one night. The place was sold out, and about two-thirds of the way back on the ground floor, he had there were four seats in a row. He brought these four people and shined the light in. There's a guy laying across the seats. What? And he said, "Sir, you'll have to move. The seats are taken." And the guy went, "Ah." And they said, "Sir, you'll have to move. Those seats are taken." And the guy went, "Ah." "Sir, where'd you come from?" He said, "The balcony."
Be very careful tonight. Our producer announced that we have no insurance for anything.
You brought a condom.
Yeah, he's in good health. You're in good health tonight, aren't you? Are you safe overall?
Oh, fairly safe. I'm wearing a full body condom.
Can't ask for anything more than that, George. God, smut will prevail.
Okay, now we'd like to do a song we released in 1963 in San Francisco. And at that time, they had two FM stations would only play this song very late at night because we were the first ones to release a song on the airways with a four-letter word on it. And the AM stations who still made the hits at the beginning of the time, right between 63 and 65, when it was still really, really heavy, and that got worse later on.
Yeah.
Strike this.
Where is it?
The AM station said, either get rid of the word or you don't have a hit. The Vince Plapp told us they wouldn't play it. So we went back to Capitol Records in Los Angeles, which in those days was a fairly tall, round, green, dirty building with a needle on the top of it, which it still is. Tooled up the whole studio in order to do this over the word in question. Tonight, we'd like to do it in its raw, uncensored form. And show you filth, 1963.
If any of you older people have trouble with this word, ask somebody younger that might be sitting at your table. They can explain it to you.
Shit, you're gonna love this.
Some people say I'm a no count. Others say I'm no good.
Very few.
But I'm just a natural born traveling man, doing what I think I should. Oh yeah, doing what I think I should.
Here it is.
And I don't give a damn about a green flat.
Oh, that was it.
Spend it fast as I can. More Waylon song and a good guitar. The only things that I understand. Oh boy, the only things that I understand.
Go. When I was a little baby, my mama said, hey son,
get out,
travel where you will and go.
what must be sung.
Oh, yeah.
Sing what must be sung.
Here it is again.
And I don't give a damn about a greenback dollar. Spend it fast as I can for a wailing song and a good guitar. The only things that I understand, oh boy, the only things that I understand.
Now the I'm a grown man, I've traveled here and there. I've learned that a bottle of brandy and a song, the only ones who ever care,
oh boy, the only ones who ever care. And I don't give a damn about a greenback dollar. Spend it fast as I can for a wailing song and a good guitar. The only things that I understand,
oh boy,
the only things that I understand,
oh yeah.
The only things that I understand,
oh boy,
the only things that I understand. I don't give a damn about a greenback.
Alright.
Spend it fast as I can for a wailing song and a good guitar. The only things that I understand,
oh boy,
the only things that I understand,
oh yeah.
The only things that I understand,
oh boy,
the only things that I understand.
All right.
Are the Oilers here this evening, or what's all this damn whistling?
All right.
You can get more.
You can get more with a kind word and a gun than with just a kind word. McNamara, 58.
When you're up to your rear end in mud, it's okay to wet your pants.
Who said that?
John Tower, 89.
Tell me.
Okay. Here's a song by Fred Neil that we sang many years at parties and stages and everything. You know, lots of people did, but there were only about three people who ever recorded this song, Fred Neil and Harry Nilsson, and somebody else did it too.
The Shirelles, the Temptations?
I don't know.
Def Leppard?
Def Leppard.
Eh?
Okay. This song was done by a guy in a movie that made it different. And so George developed an idea about this song that he should pass on to you.
Well, it's important to listen to the lyrics of a song. The lyrics in this song speak about people's inner paranoia. I like to stare at paranoid people just to confirm their suspicion.
Called Everybody's Talking at Me.
You knew it, huh? Everybody's talking at me. I don't hear a word to say. Only the echo in my mind. People stop and staring. I can't see their faces. Only the shadow of their eyes. Going where the sun keeps shining through the falling rain. Going where the weather suits my clothes.
cranking off of the northeast wind, sailing on a summer breeze, skipping over the ocean like a stone. Banking off of the northeast wind, sailing on a summer breeze, skipping over the ocean like a stone. Everybody's talking at me, I don't hear a word that says, only the echo in my mind. I won't let you leave my love behind. No, I won't let you leave my love behind.
Thank you very much.
Don't know that. I haven't relearned it. I haven't been back one. Cut it for time.
Did people forget, you know? That's the Vulcan peace symbol, remember?
Vulcanize this.
Okay. We started off playing calypso music. That's how we got Kingston. And we've never been there. I mean, Chamber of Commerce there, they've even thought to bring us here. Anyway, we start off at calypso because we like calypso songs. Most of the ones we learned in those days were risque. And they had straight English translation and straight calypso translations and then straight risque translations. Oh, here's one of the songs that they played on the radio when they wouldn't play Greenback Dollar.
Filthy.
Suggestive.
Suggestive.
Get in Trinidad and lift the family. With much confusion, as you will see, there was a mama and a papa and a son who was young, who wanted to marry, have a wife of his own. Oh, 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 ah, me. Shame and scandal among the family. Oh, 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 ah, me. Shame and scandal among the family.
So we found a young girl, we treated him nice. He went to his papa to ask his advice. Papa said, son, I've got to say no. Girl is your sister, but your mama don't know.
Oh, oh, ah, me. Shame and scandal on the family. Oh, oh, ah, me. Shame and scandal on the family.
So the weeks went by, the boy looked around. Soon the best cook on the island he found. He went to his papa to name the day. Papa looked at him and to him he did say, you can't marry that girl, I got to say no. Girl is your sister, but your mama don't know.
How old are me? Shame and scandal on the family. How old are me? Shame and scandal on the family.
When the years went by and he wished he was dead, he had 17 girls but still wasn't wed. When he asked his papa, Papa'd always say no.
Girls are your sister.
sister, but your mama don't know.
I woe I mean, Seamus can't deal with the family. I woe I mean, Seamus can't deal with the family. So he went to his mama and he bowed his head. He told his mama what his papa had said. His mama said, son, go man, go.
Your papa ain't your papa, but your papa don't know.
How woe I be. Seamus Kendall of the family. How woe I be. Seamus Kendall of the family.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you very much. I'd like to now do a medley of my hit. The boys let me do this one tonight. This song was written by two ladies in Boston, and it was for their mayoralty candidate. They wrote this song sort of as a theme song and a fight song. And their candidate lost the race, and the subway fares did go up.
Well, let me tell you the story of a man named Charlie on that tragic and fateful day.
Yeah, tell it.
He put tension in his pocket, kissed his wife and family, went to ride on that MTA.
Well, when he ever returned, no, he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever, beat the streets of Boston, he's the man who'll never be returned.
Charlie handed in his dime at the second street station, and he knew he had to change at Main. When he got there, the conductor told him one more nickel, Charlie couldn't get off of that train.
Well, when he ever returned, no, he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever beneath the streets of Boston, he's the man who'll never return.
Now, all night long, Charlie rides through the station crying, what will become of me? How can I afford to see my sisters in Chelsea or my cousin in Roxbury?
Well, if he ever returned, no, he never returned, and his fame is still unlearned.
Right where he handy,
he may ride forever beneath the streets of Boston, the man who'll never be returned.
Charlie's wife goes down to the Scully Square station every day at 2:15. And through the open window she has Charlie's sandwich as the train comes rumbling through.
Well, did he ever return? No, he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever beneath the streets of Boston, he's the man who'll never return.
You citizens of Boston, don't you think it's a scandal how the people have to pay and pay?
Yes.
Fight the fare increase, vote for George O'Brien, get poor Charlie off that MTA.
But if he ever returned, no, he never returned, and his fate is still unheard. He may ride forever beneath the streets of Boston, he's the man who'll never be returned.
He's the man who never be returned. He's the man who never be returned. A to Charlie.
Thank you very much. Too nice to me. Thank you very much. Just a little something I did years ago.
The guitar is great. The strings are crappy.
Who was the band? The band.
I would now like to introduce you to the people who travel with us.
Bring them on out of the dressing room.
Okay.
Stay back there, Phoebe. God knows we don't want the sun to shine on you.
Directly behind me, a young man who majored in percussion at the University of Texas. He was voted the best skin beater in his class. He also plays the drums. So well that he was the drummer for the 1971 All-American College Band. He's been with us for 14 years. He has always been our token freak. He joined us with very long hair and the diamond earring, which I ripped out and ate. And he has a tattoo of a cobra on his back, and he told us his nickname was Snake. And we have always just called him Dog Breath. Our dear friend for 14 years, a great guy and a great drummer, Mr. Tom Green on drum. An electric viola and an electric tenor guitar, two rather unusual instruments played by a rather ordinary man. A man who used to have his own acid bluegrass group in Wisconsin called the Foggy-Minded Mountain Boys. The great talent of another dear friend for 14 years and a fellow who's my gin partner, and he's ahead now, damn him. Mr. Ben Schubert. Then we have this. Been with us a little over a year. One of the finest bass players I've ever heard. He plays what we call a Swiss Army bass. He's from Seattle, Washington. Mr. Paul Gabrielson. He was just here a minute ago.
Oh, there he is.
Hey, man.
George Grove joined us 14 years ago. He was the first guy to sing with our group who majored in music. He majored in piano and trumpet. It's really been handy. A product of the Nashville School, he has been a producer, director, singer, picker, engineer. He's written jingles for 17 years, and jingles never wrote back once. Called your room one night, I know.
It's so embarrassing.
I would like to have you meet a man who certainly, above all else, needs absolutely no introduction whatsoever.
I hate begging for it. It's like being at home. I'd like to thank Bob for that wonderful introduction. Bob Shane is a man about whom I say, he ain't my brother, he's just heavy. I have been informed that the talcum truck will arrive between shows for you folks. We travel around the country 30 weeks out of every year as the Kingston Trio. Oh, about 6 months ago, we tried it for a while as the Pointer Sisters. And during those 30 weeks, we try to play as many of the old Kingston Trio songs as we can that make this indigenously a Kingston Trio performance. Songs like MTA, Tom Dooley, Scotch and Soda, Where Have All the Flowers Gone, Worried Man, Reverend Mr. Black, Tijuana Jail, Feelings. But every now and then we put in something new. We do that during what we euphemistically refer to as our solo segment. We're there. This is a song that I had just recently learned at soundcheck this afternoon. A song written by a dear friend of mine, a a young writer who is one of the more talented people that I've come across in the country. His name is Andy Elliott. Andy's not very well known in the greater Houston area. He's a very talented fellow. And he writes songs about men and women and trains and donkeys and just to give him a subject. This is a song of his, a simple love song entitled Everything.
I'm alone, 'cause tonight you're gone. The night wind heaves a heavy sigh, and so do I. I'm staring at the TV screen with eyes mostly blind. I've got you on my mind, and I'm feeling a little lost. I'm feeling a little empty. I'm feeling I have forgotten to say. You are the sun to me. You are the only one. You make my heart see. You are everything. I'm thinking of how I am sometimes. I act like you're not there, but still you care. So I wonder, do you know you're all that I desire? I guess darkness is the place to study fire. And I'm feeling a little lost. I'm feeling a little empty. But I'm feeling I will remember to say. You are the sun to me. You are the only one. You make my heart see. Are everything. You are the sun to me. You are the only one. You make my heart sing. You are everything.
How many of you here really enjoy good country music? Okay. That's the universal sign for stopping. How many of you here, and be honest with me, really don't care that much for country music?
That's good.
How many of you is from Fort Worth and did not understand either question? We'd like to do a real country song for y'all, Rashi.
Let's see what country today.
Chile.
Chile, all right. Oh, it's just sour grapes. We started our act in 1957 at a club that seated 92 people in San Francisco called the Purple Onion. And we started off singing calypso music, which is how we got the name Kingston. All the songs we sang were calypso. Even the folk songs we sang were to a calypso beat. In 1958, we put out an album that they pulled Tom Dilley off of. It sold 3 million records in 2 weeks, and a guy from Capitol Records came to us with a trunk full of money and said, here, you're folk singers. And we said, you bet your ass we are. We were all business school students. We knew exactly what we were doing. The American way.
I never saw the trunk of money, Bob.
I'm sure sorry about that.
We must have a little chat between shows.
In 1959, after selling this load of records and them calling us the folk singers and starting this big folk boom, they had not added a folk category to the second year of the Grammys in 59. They wanted to give us a Grammy. So they had added another new category for the second year, which we won for the best country and western group of the year.
Whoopee. Willie Nelson was thrilled.
Little Nellie Wilson.
Here's a song that was written
in
the early 60s, but it always sounded like it was written in 1860.
On a cold, dark night, there was someone killed beneath the town hall light. There were two at the scene, but they all agreed the slayer who ran looked a lot like me. But just said, son, what is your alibi? If you were somewhere else, you'd hold a half to die. I spoke not a word, though it meant my life. I was in the arms of a best friend's wife. She walked these hills in a long black veil. Nobody knows, nobody sees, nobody knows but me. Eternity near, she stood in the crowd and shed not a tear. And sometimes at night, when the cold wind moans, she kneels on my grave and cries on my bones. She walks these hills in a long black veil. The night with rain. Nobody knows, nobody sees, nobody knows but me. Nobody knows, nobody sees, nobody knows.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. All right.
And now...
What?
We don't know it.
Wasn't she at one of our shows about a year and a half ago here in Houston? Yeah. I sometimes forget a face, but I never forget a dress.
Or someone who's just gotten out of one.
Well, as you can tell, nothing really sacred for us up here. We all go to church every Sunday. Of course, our church only has 6 commandments. That's well, it has 10, but it's 6 real commandments and 4 do the best you can. So. Yeah.
Well.
Nick Reynolds will now sing a song, which I am sure that he'll have you singing along. It's a great song.
Thank you, Bob.
You're going to tell him what it is. You know what it is, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Sure.
I know this looks like show business and all the glitter and excitement, but back in this dressing room, it's all glitter and excitement.
This next song I learned from Freddie Hellerman of the Weavers. And I lived, for the last 20 years, I lived up on a ranch in Oregon, raising cattle and kids. And not necessarily in that order. But people would say, boy, it must have been really neat. You grab your guitar out of the closet and, you know, sit around the fire up there where it's raining, you know, 60 inches a year, and sing some songs to your kids, and I bet you all sang along, right? No way. I'd bring my guitar up and they'd say, Dad, don't embarrass me. Oh, God, square old songs. We want to watch MTV. We didn't have any TV. Oh! Anyway, this one song I sang to them. All the kids were born right at home on the ranch. Midwife and my wife and I. And occasionally the doctor would show up, but always too drunk to do anything. I sang this song for the kids before they got old enough to tell me to shut up. So I'd like to dedicate it to all my children. And I love them dearly, and I'll see them tomorrow. And about halfway through the song, I'd like to have you sing along with me, if you would, please. Go to sleep, you weary hobo. Watch the towns go drifting by. Can't you hear the whales a-singing? That's the hobo's lullaby. Don't you worry about tomorrow. Let tomorrow's come and go. Tonight you've got a nice warm boxcar, free from all the wind and snow. Try it. Go to sleep, you weary hobo. Go to sleep, you weary hobo. Watch the towns go drifting by. Watch the towns go drifting by. Can't you hear the rails a-singing? Can't you hear the rails a-singing? That's the hobo's lullaby. That's the hobo's lullaby.
Boy, you're great.
I know the police cause you trouble. They cause trouble
when you die and go to heaven, there'll be no policeman there. Go to sleep, you little hobo. Go to sleep, you little hobo. Watch the towns go drifting by. Watch the towns go drifting by. Can't you hear the rails a-singing? Can't you hear the rails a-singing? That's the hobo's lullaby. That's the hobo's lullaby. Can't you hear the rails a-singing? Can't you hear the rails a-singing? Oh, Johnny. That's the hobo's lullaby. Thank you. You sound good. You're damn good out there. Thank you very much. Thanks, Jenny, Johnny, and Annie, and Josh. All right. Throughout history, there have been many songs written about the Eternal Triangle. This next one tells the story of a Mr. Grayson. Beautiful woman, and a condemned man named Tom Dooley. When the sun rises tomorrow, Tom Dooley must hang. Sing along on this.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Pull for your pound and die. I met her on the mountain, then I took her life. Met her on the mountain, stabbed her with my knife.
Try a little harmony.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Who boy, you found to die. Time tomorrow, reckon where I'll be. Hadn't it been for Grayson, I'd have been in Tennessee.
All together now.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry. Oh boy, well, hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Oh boy, you're bound to die. This time tomorrow, reckon where I'll be. Down in some lonesome valley, hanging from a wide oak tree. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry, oh boy. Well, hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Poor boy, you're bound to die. Oh, well, now, boy, hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Poor boy, you're bound to die. Poor boy, you're bound to die. Poor boy, you're bound to die. Poor boy, you're bound to die.
They were wondering where to tape this show, you know, the sort of thing we do. We said, Texas, down in Houston at Rockefeller's. That's where we want to go.
That's where I want to stay.
We, with another group, the Kingston Trio, we played here, I think, the first year they opened the place. It was about 7, 8 years ago.
Like that?
And we've always wanted to play here again. It's got a nice old bank feel to it. You know, it's nice to meet some bankers who lost. Now we'd like to do a song we wrote in 1958. When we wrote this song, it meant very little. Today it means even less. It's a song about incest, greed, and lust. Story of a boy and his dog.
Starring John Provost as Timmy.
It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. I'm worried now, but I won't be worried long.
Got myself a brand new house, 5 miles out of town. Got myself a brand new car, $30 down. Got myself a cow named Sue, fixed me really fine. She's my baby. And I love her all the time.
It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. I'm worried now, but I won't be worried long.
Now I've been away on a business trip, traveling all around. I got a gal and her name is Sue, prettiest gal in town. Sets my mind to worrying every time I'm gone out at home tonight. So I won't be worried long.
It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. I'm worried now, but I won't be worried long.
In the living room, holding hands with Sue. George is at that big front door, about to come on through. Well, I'm here in the closet. Oh, Lord, what shall I do?
But come out of the closet.
We're worried now.
You ever see the California Karate Chop?
No, Bob.
Bitch.
But it won't be worried long.
It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. I'm worried now, but I won't be worried long.
Lock us out, right?
Locked us out of the dressing room.
They locked the vault.
Really?
Yeah, you want to do that now?
We'd like to... Thank you. Actually, I recorded all these tunes you're requesting. Look at them. I get cranky back here. This next song is the most... requested song ever requested of the trio. And obviously, the three of us didn't do it. Bobby Shane did it all by himself at Capitol Records in Hollywood in 1958. It's called Scotch and Soda.
I read recently where Hank Williams Jr. had three songs that he'd sung 10,000 times. I have 17 songs I've sung 20,000 times. I have two songs I've sung 23,000 times. And I have one song I've sung 27,000 times. So I called the people that wrote the article about him, and they said, you're older.
scotch and soda, but in your eyes, baby, do I feel high of me, oh my. Do I feel high? Try martini, sugar and gin. Oh, what a spell you've got me in. Oh, my. Do I feel high? People won't believe me. They'll think that I'm just bragging. But I could feel the way I do, still be on the wagon. All I need is one of your smiles, sunshine of your eyes on me, oh my. Do I feel higher than a kite can fly? Give me loving, baby, I feel high.
We learned this next song in Chicago from a real hobo. We know this is the only real hobo we ever met. We met people who claimed to be, but this guy wrote this song and made a bunch of money, and he went out and bought a yellow Cadillac convertible back in about 1961, I think it was. He since got sued for the song. Somebody else had a copyright on the melody before he stole it. So he lost all his money, but he still drives around Chicago, and you'll see this yellow Cadillac convertible parked under a lot of train trestles going across the country. A bunch of bums hanging out there just throwing up and having a good time.
Well, no matter where I wander, I know I'll always find a welcome at the end of every journey. There'll be friendly people waiting. California would not hold me, though I love her timber mountains, worked her fields and worked her orchards, up and down her central valley.
I have driven open highways across the golden Utah land, and I watch the rivers gently gliding. I wave my hand to friendly people.
California would not hold me, though I love her timbered mountains, worked her fields and worked her orchards, up and down her central valley.
Folks who know me call me a drifter. They don't know I'll stop my rambling. They don't know that someday, somewhere somebody's gonna make me settle down.
I'm going home, Lord, I'm going home. I'm going home, Lord, I'm going home. Well, no matter where I wander, I know I'll always find a will.